You know what really stinks about Notion? The fact that I'll just brain dump. And this isn't the case with just Notion, okay? I know I'm just talking about it from a writing standpoint, but when you're writing inside of Notion or any other platform, you constantly have this thing happen where you're like, okay, here are all my ideas. And there's just way too many ideas being written out, right? Like for me, I have this entire content brain dump section that's really frustrating to look at. And I can't stand looking at it, but what I want to be able to do is to take all of these different ideas and categorize them, but I just kind of brain dumped them. I was going through Twitter and looking at inspiration of different things I saw in order to write my own posts about my own experience. So how do I categorize these things? Well, what I can do is use something called ZenoChat. Thanks to the sponsor of this video, TextCortex. So if I log into TextCortex, whether it be on my browser, or they actually do have a really great Mac app, I can go into ZenoChat. And what's great about this is not only does it have just its normal writing capabilities, but there is the ability to add different knowledge bases, the ability to add specific personas, which I would definitely check out. There's a bunch of them, like whether it be the scientist, the programmer, the copywriter. I'm gonna pick the copywriter for this case. And you can make your own personas as well inside of this platform. But what I'm gonna do here, so I'm gonna say, okay, take these different bullet points below and categorize them into different sections for me to write tweets about their concepts. All right, so I'm gonna paste this out, then press enter. Ooh, look at that. Actually really did a great job of this. We have section 1, personal development. Section 2, productivity and time management. Section 3, business and entrepreneurship. Cool. So what I'm going to do now is take these. I'm going to press copy. I'm going to go back into my Notion. I'm going to do a little toggle block to original ideas so I can just like quickly organize them. And then now I'm going to put organized ideas. All right. So then we have section 1, personal development. And I can go through all of these different things and check out my calendar, find the social media post that I want to do. And you'll see that I already have these scheduled out for a while, but I just want to kind of add them to my calendar. So what I can do is I can just go back and forth between these ideas now in a much easier format. And for example, say I want to try to spread out the different concepts, right? I could say, okay, less executions, more action. The solution is simple, right upon that. And I can separate it into a more like, let's talk about this stuff once a week. You know, I don't really want to talk about this stuff too often, so I can just spread it out by then going to the other category, schedule a month, 4 hours. Yep, that was something cool that I did. Then I can talk about that. I can do that on another day of the later next week beyond that, and then go to section 3 and then follow that same process, right? We're just essentially spreading out the different concepts so it's not just a bunch of concepts on the same day and multiple days in a row, since I tweet twice a day and post LinkedIn post twice a day. Now, what if I wanted to expand on one of these ideas? I want to get some ideas from ZenoChat in order to help me out regarding this. So write me a longer LinkedIn post about this subject below. People think choices make them happy. Perception of control, well, undefined framework actually does as the concept. Then you notice it actually did a pretty good job of giving me some insight here. As a society, we have come to believe that our choices are what bring us happiness. We think the ability to choose our own paths in life and make decisions would lead to fulfillment. However, recent research has shown that there may be a different factor at play. It's the perception of control within a defined framework. And then it expands upon it. This is really cool. Hemingway is a pretty good persona to write, clearly, because this is some great ideas. Now, I'm probably not going to use this exactly, but I will in here basically go back to my social media calendar, put this on a certain day. And anytime I make a new piece of content in here, the script that's inside this will essentially have what I call a brain dump section. So I can just take this, copy it, and I'm gonna upvote it because I actually really liked it. And then paste it out in here. And this is gonna be the brain dump for which I will write the LinkedIn post and tweet. Maybe it'll inspire me to look up some of that research. It'll inspire me to obviously pare this down a lot for Twitter. But usually I utilize AI to enhance my own writing or utilize it as a thought provoker for different things. And TextCortex has a really great model, definitely different than what there is in Notion or ChatGPT or any of these other products. So if you want to find a more improved way to organize your content, I haven't found great success with Notion AI. So if you're looking for something that is a little bit more robust and more dedicated to this, please check out TextCortex today. With that being said, thank you so much for watching this video, and we'll see you in the next one.